Before I run out of time here, Chris, let me get to this issue. We had Governor Greitens on yesterday. Yes. He was nice enough to call into the show while he was in St. Louis, held that news conference where he's placing the highway patrol over here to basically take care of the roads while the police can concentrate on other things. Can I just tell you something?
Yes.
From a speeding point of view, so sometimes I take Highway 40. Sometimes I take Highway 44. I rarely take 70, but occasionally I'll take 70 or in out of the city. I don't ever remember seeing a traffic stop by St. Louis police officers on any of those three interstates. So I'm pretty sure they already weren't monitoring those roads. So maybe having the Highway Patrol there helps a little bit, but I'm still not sure that's the answer to the fixing the crime problem in North City.
Well, I mean, I take what the governor said. Does he want to get these highway patrolmen out on the out on the street so they can do the tickets and all that, and have these people, the officers, going around in these different communities? I mean, St. Louis is out of control. It is embarrassing. I mean, I would be afraid to ride the Metrolink. I would be afraid to go downtown and watch a ball game. I mean, I was thinking about it yesterday. It's kind of an extra tax in a sense that if I go down to the ball game, I'm going to pay the $100 to vote to park 10 feet from the stadium instead of having to walk way away from somewhere and be subject to being carjacked or mugged.
Yeah, I don't know if it's $100, but I do remember during a playoff game a few years ago when I was working at Channel 4, and power of capitalism, those lots right under Highway 40, right across the street, were like, it was like 50 or 60 bucks to park there during the play. It was a playoff game.
Yeah. It's almost worth it because, you know, after that young man last year, that him and his fiance were walking back to their car by the old cathedral and that incident happened. So, you know, and you know, we've seen our two mayors, this woman and Slay, nothing's going on. I mean, one of the things that they were using for crime prevention in North St. Louis is they would put empty police cars in certain bad neighborhoods. Somehow that's supposed to stem crime by an empty police car just standing there in a neighborhood. I mean, no one's doing something. Something needs to be done. I applaud the governor for taking bold action and taking the criticism from people for doing this.
City-county merger. I had him out on. I said, listen, you know, he brought up the fact that St. Louis is the most dangerous city in America. We need to do something about it. I said, that sticks in the craw of people like Georgia Walker, who the former ambassador who wrote a letter to the editor in the Post yesterday from Better Together. They think that St. Louis has a bad image that would be improved if we were one big community and blah, de, blah, de, blah. I said, what do you think about the merger? And he gave me an answer about crime. And I'm like, no, what I'm asking you specifically is, what do you think about the city-county merger? And he still didn't answer my question. And then I finally said, do you really think it's fair that this may go on a statewide ballot and crush, disenfranchise the voters in St. Louis County and St. Louis City who would not have their own say over how their government was going to be run? It would be decided by somebody in Cape Girardeau or Springfield or Kansas City. And he still didn't give me a great answer other than to say it's something he'd need to look at and see how it benefited the region.
I think you've may have spurred some action because, you know, this morning the Post-Dispatch said that he's selling his house in the central West End. He put it up for sale.
Is that right?
So maybe you may have spurred that.
He's getting the hell out while the getting's good.
Exactly. You know, when I was saying during the break that unfortunately he does live in St. Louis City because he can't say, hey, I don't have any dog in this fight because I live somewhere else. So, you know, he lives in the city, so he is kind of...
I want to get him on again because I was a little disappointed that he wouldn't take a stand on that. He should stand up and scream from the governor's mansion. It is not fair to put to a statewide ballot and override the wishes of the voters of St. Louis County because these people in Better Together, these people that support this, they know if it goes to a vote, St. Louis County will vote it down.
In the governor's defense, I think he wanted the news yesterday to be his crime initiative, not governor supports city county
merger.
Well,
I'll see what I can do to change that.
So,
thank you.
I think that may have had a little something to do with it.
Chris Arps, you're the best, my friend.
Thank you
for coming in. Congratulations on your engagement, by the way, in case I forget to mention that. Way to go. All right.